Hello and Happy New Year! Today I would like to show you a setup for FPV control and long range transmission, the one I'm using with my 350QX. I will try to explain how and why I did it that way. As you can see, because I have to carry more than a radio transmitter alone, I find it more convenient to use a harness on which I can hook a tray. The tray is almost compulsory in that case, because if you do FPV, you have a bunch of components tied into the transmitter, like a 2.4 GHz amplifier, the video receiver, and your antennas. I found on eBay a plexiglass tray, custom cut for the DX6i, but they also do it for other models of Spectrum. And if I chose plexi over wood or carbon, it's just because plexi is very light, easily cuttable, drillable, waterproof, it's transparent, and this particular model has an intelligent hook system and sufficient space on sides to insert stuff like battery. So the first thing I did was adding 430mm rubber legs to the tray, so what's under cannot be squeezed, or the tray cannot be unstable when the transmitter is laying on a plane surface or resting in a case. My second idea was to feed power to all components with a single 4S battery connected to multiple noiseless voltage regulators. I did that with a simple aluminum angled bracket and a Velcro tied to the metal mount of the tray. To control the voltage at all times, I've added a cheap voltmeter on the front face of the tray, and a main on-off switch is there to allow power for all electronics at the same time. Voltage regulators, a UBEX, a video monitor, the 1.3 GHz video receiver, and the 2.4 GHz signal amplifier. I've also managed to modify the input of the transmitter so it's no longer powered by the inner AA batteries but directly from a 6-volt UBEX. If I used a 15-volt 4S battery and not a 12-volt, it's because in order to deliver the proper voltage, 12-volt regulators usually need at least 2-volt difference between input and output current. This small regulator is screwed to the back of the tray, as well as the 5 and 6 volts UBEX. To kill or at least to limit radio frequency noise, I've used many ferrite rings at all stages before and after regulators. Another decision to take if you want to use a Wi-Fi booster is to remove the original 2dBi antenna from the transmitter and replace it with a reverse polarity SMA mount. So now I can either easily mount my own antennas picked between a bunch of different gains from 2 to 10dBi depending on my needs, or if I need more emitting power for long range transmission for instance, I can unscrew the antennas and replace it by a right angle SMA socket that I will screw on the transmitter and then drive the signal to a cable from the transmitter output to the Wi-Fi amplifier signal input and at last to a flat panel antenna with a higher gain and better directivity. Because of the plexiglass tray, I've been able to screw the patch antenna mount directly on it and have the ability to change the orientation either vertically or horizontally depending on the situation. This kind of antenna is perfect for very long range transmission, especially when connected to an amplifier. Note that when using a booster, the input signal from the transmitter must usually never exceed 50 milliwatts, or else you just kill the amplifier. So a mic transmitter is set to 10 milliwatts. Beside the antenna for the transmitter, there is the antenna for the video receiver. I personally chose a 4-lobe cloverleaf antenna, which is a true omnidirectional antenna, and I positioned it so it faces the ground or the sky horizontally. This antenna is connected to a 12 channels 1.3 GHz receiver, and I used a 1360 MHz frequency, so there is no harmonic frequency near 2.4 that could interfere with the transmitter frequency. I also use a 1.3 GHz low-cut filter to avoid all unwanted frequencies above 1.3. This filter can either be mounted on the video transmitter or on the receiver. I personally prefer to connect it to the receiver so I spare unwanted weight on the 350QX. A strong cable will now feed the monitor with the video signal. Most of my cables start and end with a right angle socket. Best way, in my opinion, to avoid breakage and to keep cable length as short as possible. I also make good use of small Velcro scratch cable tights. To handle the video monitor, I bought a cheap but sturdy and very light carbon fiber mount that can be found on eBay for a few bucks. And now the back of my transmitter looks a little bit messy, but it's not. And the total weight is fair, especially with the harness. The front is clear, and your wrists can rest nicely while you're controlling remotely your bird. I hope this little video gave you some ideas to improve your own setup, and I'll come back soon for other advice. Thanks for watching, and see you soon. Bye!